Hello, Russian learners. I'm Anastasia, and I'm happy to welcome you to another Russian Questions Trainer episode here at RusPro channel. Today, we are practicing the question who in Russian when asking about plural animate nouns, particularly about family members and close people. So it's gonna be an interesting lesson. Let's achieve it! First of all, let's do a short review and practice asking this question about singular animate nouns. So, if you haven't watched lessons number 1 and 3 of this series, pause this video right now and go to the playlist Russian Questions Trainer. If you have watched them, here's an exercise for you. And let's do it right now. As usual, please choose one of the two options in brackets. Pause the video, say your answer out loud, then listen to me say the correct answer. Кого она любит? Дочку и сына. Object forms: дочку, feminine noun, сына, masculine noun. Кто любит жену? Муж. Asking about the subject using кто, choosing the subject form муж. Кого любит жена? Мужа. Asking about the object, choosing the object form. Кого ты часто видишь? Маму и папу. Here we have object forms, у ending in both words. That is why we use кого. Мама is a feminine noun, ending у in the object form. Папа is a masculine noun, but ending in а, so changing just like a feminine noun. Again, ending у. Кого ты редко видишь? Бабушку и дедушку. Same thing. Бабушка feminine, у, дедушка masculine, but ending in а. Also, у ending in the object form. And кого, the object who. Very good. I hope you got it right. And now let's move on to the plural nouns. It's always difficult with Russian nouns denoting people because in their plural forms they have quite a few exceptions. But I grouped them for you so that it will be easier for you to remember them, to memorize them. So let's take a look first at this group. You can see that here we have кто, the subject forms, and кого, the object forms. So let's take a look at each noun here. Parents. Subject form. Родители. Кто? Object form. Родителей. Кого? Children. Subject form. Дети. Object form. Детей. Daughters. Дочери. Дочерей. Emphasis is here. Sons. Сыновья. Subject form. Сыновей. Object form. Friends. Друзья. Subject form. Друзей. Object form. Brothers. Братья. Subject. Братьев. Object. Emphasis stays here. People. Люди. subject and людей object. So you can see for these nouns, ей is a common ending in the object form. Now we will see how it works in the example, in the real dialogue. And one more thing here. The word for my, if you want to say my friends, my children, and so on. Мои is the subject form, and моих will be the object form. So let's take a look at the example. Кого вы хотите пригласить на юбилей? So, who do you want to invite to the jubilee or anniversary? By the way, in Russian, the word юбилей corresponds to the date when the person turns like 50 or 60 or 30 or 40, so any, we call it a round date, круглая дата, юбилей. And in this sentence, we started with кого, because we are looking for the object when we ask this question. Who do you want to invite? You are the subject, because you are inviting someone. And who is this someone? Who is the object of invitation? Кого? And this person will answer родителей, детей, дочерей, сыновей, братьев, друзей, много людей. So in the answer, we will use only the object forms because we asked for the object. And here you can see this ей ending works for nearly every noun, except for brothers. The object form of brothers is братьев. We come back to that when we speak about another group of nouns. And one more nuance here. After the word много, you will use this form also. So, many people will always be много людей, many children, много детей, many friends, много друзей, and so on. So the same form is used after the word много. If you wanted to say my here, by the way, it's not necessary to say my when talking about members of your family, children, husband, wife, sister, brother. In Russian, it's not necessary to use the possessive pronoun because it's quite clear that we're speaking about our members of the family. So here, this person who answers the question doesn't use the word for my, but you can use it. It's possible if you want to. And since the answer is in the object form, we will use the object form of my. So we would say моих родителей, моих детей, моих братьев, and so on. But if I asked this person who is turning 50, who will be there at your юбилей? Who will be there? Who will be? Here, who is the subject? So we will use the word кто, the subject form. We cannot replace it with whom. We cannot say whom will be there, right? So only who, кто. Кто будет там? Who will be there? And the answer now will be in the subject form. Мои родители, мои родители, мои дети, мои дочери, мои сыновья, мои друзья, мои братья, мои люди,
it's not really, it doesn't really fit here, but sometimes you can say my people, right? Мои люди. So I hope you got that. Now let's practice with this group. Let's practice. Remember, always say your answer out loud.
Кого вы любите больше всего?
Моих детей.
Кто там?
Here, imagine that a husband and wife are speaking. For example, a wife is working in the garden and she didn't hear, she heard something that somebody came home, but she didn't see who it was. So the husband replies,
Кто там? Дети. Они уже дома?
Are they already at home? Subject form, because we are looking for the subject in the question.
Кто там?
Who is there?
Here,
this person, again, didn't hear the last part of this line. So, they are asking again.
Я давно не видел моих друзей.
Literally, I, for a long time, haven't seen my friends. Who haven't you seen for a long time?
Кого моих друзей?
Кого? Because we are asking about the object. Very good. Moving on to the next group.
Я люблю кошек. А вы?
Yes, кошка is a who in Russian. It's a кто. So, кошка, собака, all animals belong to the who category. That is why we use these question words for them. So now let's see. This column represents the singular forms of some animate nouns. This column is plural subject form. So subject singular, subject plural. And this is object plural. So let's see. All these nouns, собака, кошка, бабушка, дедушка, дочка, сестра, end in a. So they end in a vowel. Most of them are feminine, except for дедушка. But you already know that if a masculine noun ends in an a, it changes just like the feminine nouns. So we to form the object plural forms. Кого? We will need these forms, singular subject forms. And what do? We drop the last vowel in each noun. So, собака, собак. Я люблю собак. I love dogs in general. Dogs as an object. Кошка, we dropped a. And here we get something like кошк, which is not convenient to say. So in Russian, in this case, we add an additional vowel here. It's called a fleeing vowel. And in this case, it's Е. So we have кошек. Кошек. We need to break this cluster of consonants. Ш and К. Бабушка. Again, we dropped the А. Бабушек. Same thing. Я люблю моих бабушек. I love my grandmas. Дедушка, same thing. Дедушек. Я люблю моих дедушек. Дочка. So, this is an affectionate version of this noun. Дочек. We did the same thing. Я люблю моих дочек. I love my daughters. Affectionate. If it's я люблю моих дочерей, it's more neutral. And я люблю моих дочек, more kind of nice, affectionate version of it. And сестра, sister, we drop the а, сестер. Here the emphasis stays on the ending, that is why it's ё, not е. Ё is always emphasized in Russian. So, я люблю моих сестер. I love my sisters. Let's look at more examples. Кого ты любишь больше? Собак или кошек? So, who do you love more, dogs or cats? We use кого here for the object, because you are the subject you love, and собак and кошек are also the object forms. And the reply is я люблю бабочек. I love butterflies. So, бабочка will be a butterfly, singular form, singular subject form, and we again add this е vowel here to break the cluster of consonants. Бабочка, бабочек. Do not confuse it with бабушка, бабушек. Okay, so this is butterfly, бабочка, and бабушка, grandma. So, number two. Сейчас я вижу моих бабушек и дедушек только в скайпе. I only see now or lately, I only see my grandmas and grandpas on Skype. Again, object form. Я вижу, subject, я, verb, вижу, бабушек. Кого? Бабушек и дедушек. Very good. Let's take a look at the third group and then we'll practice again. Mostly masculine animate nouns in this group. And let's see what happens to their plural form in the object position. So if a masculine noun ends in a consonant, just a consonant, for example, внук, кот, we have the ov ending. Внук, внуков. Here о is unstressed, so we reduce it. Внуков. Я люблю моих внуков. I love my grandchildren. Кот, котов. Here о is stressed. Я люблю котов. Probably some people like male cats more than just cats in general. Maybe they think that they are easy to manage, or I don't know, they have better personality. I don't know. But you can say я люблю котов if you want to underline that you love male cats more. Now let's look at this noun. And here we have Y at the end. Y is a soft consonant in Russian. So, попугай, parrot, becomes попугаев. Ев, it's just the softer version of ov. And I love parrots will be я люблю попугаев. Object form. Брат, you already see. You have already seen this noun before. Брат, братьев. That's an exception. And it also has the ev ending. Just like this one, the soft ev ending. Now, we also have masculine nouns ending in a soft sign. For example, медведь or учитель. And what happens to them? They acquire the already familiar ending ей. So, I love bears, plural. Я люблю медведей. You would think every Russian would say that, but that's not true. And учитель. Я люблю моих учителей. I love my teachers. Great. Now let's look at more examples. В Австралии. Actually, I should blend it together. В Австралии я видела попугаев. Много попугаев. So I saw parrots, object form. Много попугаев. Remember, after the word много, we use the same form as in the object position. Кого ты видел в лесу? Медведя? Не медведя. Медведей. So, who do you see? Or who did you see in the forest? Кого ты видел? Asking about the object. Медведя? Even though it's a separate sentence, we should keep it in the object form because it's still within the same paradigm, right? It's still asking about the object. Did you see a bear? One bear? Медведя? Не медведя. Медведей. Bears. Very good. Хорошо. And one more practice for today. And let's get to it. Final practice. Now I want you to give me some personal information. I want you to answer these questions on the board about yourself. So let me read these questions first to you, and then I want you to pause the video and answer them out loud. Choose the noun that suits you and put it in the correct form to make it the correct answer to the question. For example, кого вы хотите пригласить на юбилей? So imagine that you are going to have a jubilee soon. Or just think of your next big date. And think who you would like to invite. Choose from these nouns and put them in the correct form. For example, я хочу пригласить друзей. Okay? Next. Кого вы часто видите? Кого вы редко видите? А кого видите только по скайпу? For example, я часто вижу родителей. I often see my parents. Кого вы любите больше всего? Speaking about animals. А кого вы не любите? Я люблю кошек. А вы? So pause the video and answer these questions out loud. I hope you've done that. And I also want you to put your answers in the comment section so that I can check and correct them. By the way, if you like these type of lessons and if you like this approach, book some lessons at our online Russian language school, ARUSPRO, to get the maximum effect of this method. And by the way, All our tutors work according to this method, so you can be sure you will get the results you want. So subscribe, follow us, and we will achieve Russian proficiency together. See you soon!